From the shifting sands of Amonkhet to the busy streets of Ravnica and the roiling wilds of Zendikar, the many worlds of Magic the Gathering have been sparking the imagination of players for more than three decades. In this series, our intrepid travelers will be delving deep into Magic's history, opening one box of each core Magic booster set before playing a best-of-three match using the cards they find. In the next episode, they take their collections forward through time, opening the next set in chronological order, upgrading their decks and refining their strategies along the way. This is the Magic the Gathering Progression Series. Invasion was released in October of the year 2000 and is the first set of Invasion block. The Phyrexians have arrived in Dominaria, and all of the people of the plane have united to form the Coalition in order to fight back the colonizers. The crew of the Weatherlight and the planeswalker Urza fight alongside characters like Lord Windgrace and Freyalise as they fight to defend their home and the rest of the multiverse. The Time Mage Teferi, one of Urza's many students, in a desperate attempt to save his home region of Zalfir, phases the entire region and part of nearby Shiv out of existence in an attempt to escape the invasion. In the end, the plain of Dominaria has taken heavy losses, with only the wild forests of Yavimaya remaining as safe haven for the remaining Coalition members to take shelter. Invasion introduces several concepts that would become commonplace over time. First, the set introduces Kicker, a beloved mechanic that allows you to pay an additional kicker cost in order to magnify or otherwise alter the effects of a spell you cast. Kicker is such a broadly applicable concept that the community has a running joke about how every new mechanic that introduces an alternative cost is just another version of Kicker, a mechanic that's nearing a quarter century old at this point. Invasion also introduces cards with what would eventually become known as Domain, effects that scale based on the number of different basic land types among the lands you control. These cards are among the many that represent the themes of the Coalition uniting as one to fight off the Phyrexians, alongside a significant number of other cards that encourage playing multiple different colors to maximize their benefits. The third and final innovation of Invasion is the first ever cycle of split cards. These somewhat confusing to read cards represent multiple cards at the same time, and the player can choose to cast either spell as if it was a single card. The split cards in Invasion are all multiple colors as well, further enforcing the multicolor Coalition theme. Other notable cards include Crusading Knight, Glimmering Angel, Harsh Judgment, Obsidian Acolyte, Rout, Empress Galena, Fact or Fiction, Opt, Probe, Well-Laid Plans, Cremate, Crypt Angel, Phyrexian Delver, Breath of Daragaz, Kavu Monarch, Mage's Contest, Skizik, Elvish Champion, Kavu Titan, Saproling Infestation, Absorb, Armadillo Cloak, Artifact Mutation, Captain Sisay, Coalition Victory, Fires of Yavimaya, Sleeper's Robe, Sterling Grove, and Chromatic Sphere.
It's wheel time. Winner's wheel. I'm surprised I'm spinning the winner's wheel this week, to be honest.
I am too.
When I thought Celestial Convergence deck, I was like, oh, I'm gonna get fucking... Oh, okay. Well, there's still only one card on the ban list that I don't want to keep there. So I guess Black Lotus will be legal for next episode. So that's
hooray.
Fine. All right. And this week, Jasper is on the loser's wheel. Really, no
really
fault of his
tried.
Own. His deck was solid.
So
he just
hard.
Got some really unfortunate RNG. Ah, okay. Well, you get to limit a card.
Oh, great. I mean, I lost to Intruder Alarm again.
Yeah, well, that's already limited, so you got to choose something else.
I know!
Well, there's Gaia's
Cradle.
Carrion Elves. All
You're
right.
You're gonna
Carrion
limit
Elves.
Curie? Oh, for next episode only?
No, this one's forever. Curian Elves is limited.
Oh my god, we gotta start keeping a Google Doc.
No, just stop playing Intruder Alarm.
36 packs of Invasion, starting now. Now, see, if I was a professional, I would probably have done a little more research before opening this set. But I have forgotten basically everything contained within this set since I last looked at it. I remember now that it has Kicker in it, and Kicker is amazing. Kicker is so fun, adds such a nice modality to cards. You can have the cheaper effect or the more expensive effect that's a little splashier. Means that cards can have relatively high total mana values if you pay the kicker cost, but not be completely worthless when you draw them early, which is really, really nice. Chromatic Sphere is one of these cards that is surprisingly difficult to make rulings on, despite how innocuous it is, because the drawing a card is attached to a mana ability. There are some very funky ways that that interacts with the stack, because mana abilities are in this weird timing bracket. I don't believe they are a special action like playing lands and flipping morph creatures. But they are usually, like, in almost all circumstances, they are uninteractable, like uncounterable. And so Chromatic Sphere, drawing a card off of that kind of effect is very strange and creates some weird ruling stuff. Artifact Mutation is really, really, really good. I'm super glad to see Artifact Mutation as our first rare. This card is really good. Unreal. So, we might want to consider running these colors just for that. And Sterling Grove is pretty good, too. Holy crap. I know this card from Commander quite well. It's interesting to see some of these cards that I associate so strongly with completely different artworks and frames showing up in these surprisingly old sets. We have officially passed Y2K. Ooh, Disrupt! Holy crap! Strictly better... Force Spike hits everything. I think Force Spike is slightly better in a lot of circumstances. But Disrupt is very, very strong. Definitely something that I can see myself playing. You know, I saw the name Temporal Distortion and 3BB when I was looking ahead, and I just assumed this would be an extra turn spell. So when it's an enchantment with this many words, I get very intimidated. Okay, so it essentially just puts a stun counter on anything that gets tapped that's not an artifact. That is interesting. That's interesting. If we can, we have some artifacts that potentially allow us to win the game. I think that's going in like the potential tab. Armadillo Cloak. Armadillo Cloak is really good. We have a pretty strong aura deck in our back pocket that I haven't played in a couple episodes. And Armadillo Cloak would be a very potent addition to that deck. Oh, geez. A split card. I don't know if you can tell on the microphone because I'm trying to stay relatively equidistant, but I'm turning my head sideways. Stand and deliver. Prevent the next two damage. Okay. I think deliver's all right. I don't know about stand. The fact that they're together means that they're a little more considerable. It's like a bit of removal, or you can save one of your key creatures if you need it. I can see myself playing that eventually. Thunderscape Master seems pretty solid. Just this black tap to drain two, I can see as a legitimate win condition. Maybe we like try to jund it out. We'll see. Ooh. Tech is fun. I know this is like one of the main things that I've learned from looking at the set for research and stuff. Invasion's one of the first sets that really, really wants you to play a lot of colors. And Tech is a really good example of that. So it's a 2/2. Okay, well, it's a 4/4 if you get all of its buffs. So if you have a Plains and a Swamp,
It's a 4/4. Flying, first strike, trample. I mean, it seems fine, but you really want all of it online. Although with my dual lands, I'll look into it. I'll look into it. I think 5-color is a really compelling potential option for this. For this set, I should say. But I don't know if I want to go all the way in on it. Wax and Wane is fine. Ooh, Collapsing Borders is fun. I love all these multicolor incentive cards. It's really gonna, I think it's gonna shake up a lot of our deck construction. Oh, there's Kurian Elves. One of the unfortunate casualties of our ban list. Llanowar Elite. I think Llanowar Elite has some legs. 9-mana 6/6 isn't ideal, but because you can play it as a 1-mana 1/1, like if we play an Aura deck again, this will probably go in. I think Recoil is solid. I think Recoil is really solid, actually. Tangle's pretty good. Shimmering Wings is nice. Stormscape Apprentice is pretty nice. Maybe we can play like a burn deck. I can see myself playing a burn deck. Underworld Dreams is back. Apparently, I'll need to double check our ban list. But Underworld Dreams was banned in Legacy, which is what we're loosely going towards in terms of like overall Wizards level bans. But it's come back to 4. So that's nice. Ooh, Absorb. Absorb. I love Absorb. I like this Ravenous Rats art too. He's just chilling. He's perched. Sure. More of this Jund stuff. Scarred Puma. Ooh, Probe is kind of nice. There's some new tools for like Rack and things. And like target player loses one life. I can see like a Rack burn sort of deck forming here. And we've got a good amount of tools for that. Maybe this is the Revenge of Tim. I think Rout is playable. I don't love it, but 5-mana board wipe at sorcery speed is perfectly okay. Our best board wipe is 4-mana. Our next best one is like 8. So this is definitely within the range of playability. And the ability to play it at instant speed for 7 could be a big, big deal. If someone's playing a big board-based deck, or we just want to get to a point where we have enough mana that we can stick bigger threats first. This is not the first printing of Harrow, but I always love to see it. Wayfaring Giant could be a nice payoff for multicolor. Each basic land type, so this is Domain, so it does work with our dual lands. The cameos, maybe. It's a big maybe. Right, Pure Reflection is so interesting. Okay, so there's like, I don't know if this would be good content. I don't think this deck would function in a way that would lead to an episode that's less than like 2.5 hours, but bear with me on this. You wipe the board with something like that instant speed board wipe, then you play Pure Reflection, and your goal is that your creature spell is always going to be bigger. You have like the Sardian Colossi of the world. But the thing is, like, those reflections don't have haste. So, like, what's even the point? I don't know. Opt is nuts. I can see this card seeing a ton of play. I'd imagine Liz is going to be playing quite a lot of Opt in the future. Oh, that's really interesting. Hallam Jinn. This would be really cool as a splash in like a green ramp style deck. Exclude could be okay. Utopia Tree is a rare. A 2-mana 0/2 that taps for any color is a rare. Kavu Runner is a nice sideboard card. Divine Presence is another very interesting sideboard card. Stun is interesting. Like I don't know, it feels fillery, but it feels like a good fillery. Ooh, I like Vigorous Charge quite a lot. I think this is very nice. This is not the first Shivan Oasis. I've probably cut out when I scrolled past a couple earlier, but this is not the first Shivan Oasis. We've got some serious green-red mana fixing. I can see like green-red-white. Bog Initiate, Just the ability to mess around with colors. Second Route, holy crap. The ability to just mess around with colors is really getting enhanced by this set. I can feel it. That's probably why Kurian Elves was in here. Cimoooooo is alright, actually. There's quite a lot of things with one toughness that this kind of hoses. Crystal Spray could be interesting. Phantasmal Terrain. A lot of these, some of these are interesting color color hoser kind of cards. Holy crap, I did not realize Savrling Symbiosis exists. This is a card that wants to go in a couple of my commander decks. For each creature you control. That's very scary, potentially. Ooh, Backlash is fun. Ooh, Saproling Infestation. Whenever a player pays a kicker cost, you may put a Saproling. Or you put. You cannot. It's not a may. You must. That's very strong. For two mana? That's definitely a sideboard card, at least for this episode. I can see a lot of kicker cards getting experimented with. But in the future, that's a pretty nice payoff for a kicker-centric strategy. Right now, I don't think there's too many like cheap kickers. This is kind of cheap. There's probably some cheaper kickers we can utilize to really try and get Saproling Infestation going off. And we have the Saproling Mutation, like the artifact mutation card. That's in some of the right colors. So that's definitely something to look at. Ooh, I really like this set, actually. It's hard to tell from a Scryfall page exactly how good a lot of sets are. And this is one that's surprising me the more I look into it. Alfheim Sanctuary is pretty damn good. It's like Abundance, but worse, but 2 mana. And 2 mana is a lot less than 4. I like this dude with protection from Kavu. I don't know. I guess there's a lot of red Kavu, so I guess the idea is like red and blue are enemy colors, so they have things that hose each other. Ooh, Void is so gnarly. Just such gnarly discard cards. Oh, target player can't play lands this turn. Oh, Sway of Illusion. When I saw this card when I was looking through cards from Invasion, I pinged our Discord chat about using Sway of Illusion to target a whole bunch of black creatures and make them non-black so that Necrotal and stuff can hit them. I don't know if it's that good, but it's pretty funny. It draws a card, so the card advantage is the same. I think Sabo's Web could be very strong, potentially, but I don't think... Like, I can't think of too many lands that people actively run that have an activated ability that don't produce mana. There's, like, Volrath's Stronghold, but short of that, I can't really think of anything. But Sabo's Web, 2-mana artifact that draws a card... And has actually a pretty significant stacks kind of effect. If we're playing a strategy that can really synergize with that, that's definitely something we'd look into. Spite and Malice, solid. They're both 4 mana, which kind of sucks for either of them, but they're together. I can see Crypt Angel. Actually, I can really see Crypt Angel because I've sort of got a blue red black strategy in the back of my mind right now. Sort of a burn, just like dickhead deck, really. Just like burn, discard, hit face, counterspell, that kind of thing. Oh, Aether Rift is so funny. That's really funny. I don't know how useful it is, but it is pretty funny. And honestly, only 4 turns of that, but you have to be playing a pretty creature-heavy deck. This is going in the funny pile, for sure, for sure. I can see Kurian Sentinel being an issue later, if we have, like, mass blink effects. Dream Thrush is pretty solid. The mono blue color hoser deck is not real. I think that's our 3rd Spite and Malice, by the way. Plague Spitter is a lovely little friend. He's friend-shaped. He's spitting horrible ooze into the atmosphere, but that's not his fault. He's probably just chilling. I don't know what their deal is. Anyway, Elvish Champion is, like, ridiculous. It's unreal, ridiculously good. I don't know if we have the elf package to really make this function with one of Kurian Elves. And I don't know, we have the Trample guy. We have... The real problem I'm getting at is that we have 2 Llanowar and 2 Findhorn. We only have a grand total of 4 1-mana mana dorks for an elf deck. And I don't know if any of the other elves are really super worth it right now. But I don't know, maybe my standards are just too high because I'm being influenced by modern cards. Blurred Mongoose is solid. It's Shroud. It has Shroud, which causes some issues. I think this is why they decided with Shroud initially instead of Hexproof, which is the standard. Well, Ward nowadays, but Hexproof has become the standard for these kinds of effects before, after. But, I think why they went with Shroud early on is that it's a real hamper on aura strategies. And when equipment don't exist yet, auras are really, really, really strong. And so Shroud becomes a big downside. Like, this would be perfect if this was Hexproof instead of Shroud, because I could just slap some auras on and basically play Bogles in the year 2000. But that's not how life works. Recover could be playable. It's 3 mana to quote-unquote draw a card and then literally draw a card. Eh, it's totally playable. Oh, Riptide Crab, so good. Riptide Crab, so good. This is a nice aura target. Phyrexian Delver! I love this card. Phyrexian Delver is so good. You reanimate a Phyrexian Delver, and then the Phyrexian Delver reanimates a big creature, and you just go nuts. It's so nice. It's so good. And I have, like... What's that card? It's the card from Urza's block. This shows you how much white I play. Karmic Guide. Karmic Guide. You can Phyrexian Delver into a Karmic Guide into another guy. Just get an infinite chain of dinguses. Ooh, I think Banalish Lancer is playable. 6 mana, 4/4 first strike is kind of tough, but it's so good. It's such a bad rationale for that. But really, I just think 6 mana, 4/4, like 4 with first strike is a really big number right now. Ooh, Urborg Emissary is solid. If this had flash, this would be so good. Ooh, Marauding Knight. That's a firm sideboard. That's a firm sideboard card. I think Prohibit has legs. I don't know about playing it, but I think Prohibit has legs. Ooh, Liberate, another flicker effect. And it's an uncommon, so there's a chance I've missed one further up on the list here. This Vodalion Serpent is not terrible. It's a not terrible blue creature. 4 mana 2/2 sucks. 6 mana 6/6. Epic. Incredible, especially for blue. And the defending player controls an island clause sucks, but there are a lot of cards, even just within this set, that modulate the type of lands that are on the battlefield. Wow, this card is insane. There's a reason this is a 9 mana card. Raya Dawnbringer, if this was like 7 mana, would be so good. It's still fine, don't get me wrong. Ooh, Breath of Darragaz is really nice. That's our third route. That's really nice. I think Juntu Stakes has some legs. I don't know offhand, but at the very least, it turns off Llanowar Elves. And like, a lot of mana dorks are going to be at one or less power, basically, is what I'm getting at. So against a ramp heavy strategy, this could really hose quite a lot of their plans. Another Vigorous Charge. It's the second one I've seen, but I'm sure there's more. I think Dredge could be okay, to be totally honest. There's not really anything that is as free of a sac outlet right now that I'm aware of anyway. And usually this kind of effect is like a Village Rites where it draws 2 cards, but by year 2000 standards, being able to effectively just pop your own guy for value is pretty good. Ooh, at the very end, we get Captain Cissé. Captain Cissé is such a good card. There's a lot of shit you can do with that. That's definitely something that is good. That is really good. It's a bit of a shame that I'm recording this, because this is the kind of thing I'd like to keep in the back pocket, completely in the shadows, but that's not really something that's going to happen. Either way, I think this was a great set of pulls. I think this was a really good set of pulls. I think there's a lot of things we could be doing with a lot of these new cards, and that's lovely. That's wonderful. So we'll see what we can come up with for this week.
All right. So I was initially intending to go with a sort of Grixis burn control sort of strategy with a little bit of discard. And then I realized that we checked the ban lists and the rack is back to 3. Well, to 4, but I have 3 of them. So what eventually turned into essentially just a discard deck with a little bit of like blue control stuff in there. I still think it's going to be okay. We've got 3 rack and 2 Wheel of Torture. So we've effectively got 5 copies of rack. And we can do quite a lot with that, especially with 2 Underworld Dreams. I'm just not sure
how effectively that's really going to work. I'm not terribly confident in this deck, but I do think it's got some legs, and I think it has potential to win, so we'll see how we do.
Hey, Austin, when are you starting the recording?
Fuck
yeah, we need to get the recording started.
Shut up!
Yeah. Alright, sideboard locked, ready up.
Alright.
Have fun going first, nerd.
Ooh, already spitting.
I keep.
See, Jasper, you can already see the issues I was having in testing. I'm gonna mulligan. Oh, this is not much better.
Wow.
I suppose I will bottom this card. And then I will play an island and pass.
Fantastic. I'm going to play an island and then pass.
I see. We're evenly matched. All right, main one. I'll play Reflecting
Pool. I don't think I drew a card that turn.
I will tap two for Sapphire Medallion.
Oh, nice.
And pass.
On a roll.
I'm going to untap, upkeep, draw main one. I'm going to play this swamp. I'm going to play this Owl Familiar.
Oh, it's Owl.
Drawing a card. Discarding this Avatar of Woe and passing.
Oh, no.
Whoa.
Untap, upkeep, draw.
Oh, Jasper, let's say it in the edit.
Yeah, I know, sure. I know what that card does. That almost went in my mill deck. I will play this island. This is a sorcery. That's cringe. I will tap two for probe without the kicker. So I will draw three. And then I will discard.
Oh, hell yeah. You're doing discard again.
And this chilling apparition. And then I will. Sure. I mean, you know. I'll just play the rat.
Yeah, I know.
And I'll pass.
Oh yeah, untap, upkeep, draw my card, main one. Nice. I'm going to play this Wasteland. I'm going to tap and sack it to get rid of your Reflecting Pool.
Okay.
Then I'm going to tap two for Apprentice Necromancer, go to combat, swing in for one in the air and pass.
Oh, Apprentice Necromancer came out? This card's so good.
Yeah, it's pretty damn good.
All right, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. I will play a swamp.
You're about to get domed in the head.
I will play Ravenous Rats. Please discard a card.
This one.
All right, and then this island becomes a special boy when I cast Sunken Field, targeting the island.
Huh. Nice.
And I will pass. It's a free force spike.
Draw my card, main one. That's so funny. Well, I'm going to tap swamp, tap and sacrifice Apprentice Necromancer.
Right, Avatar of Woe exists. Okay.
Yeah, crazy, I know.
Oh, what? You didn't pull out the Owl Familiar?
I almost thought about it, but I didn't. Go into combat. I'm going to swing at you with everything.
Okay, I will block Avatar of Woe with my Ravenous Rats and take one.
Nice.
Okay.
Main two. Play this Gemstone Mine. I don't mean to tap it. Three mining counters.
I see.
Wow.
Incredible for the Parry the Pulverizer Commander deck that cares about the different types of counters on the field.
So I'm going to tap it for a black.
Okay.
Dark Ritual.
Okay.
Island, Frantic Search, floating a black.
Okay.
We're going to discard those two and then untap my lands.
What's that first one? Underground River. Okay.
Then I think I'm going to cast Manipulate Fate. You'll notice that this
Okay, yeah. It's deck thinning.
Yes.
Ugh, if only I was playing mill instead of discard this week.
Yeah, such a good matchup against Manipulate Fate.
Those are exiled. What a name. Saprazin Scary.
The present is scary.
It is quite scary. It can pay for a counterspell with a single land.
Right? Alright, I draw my card. I'll pass. On my end step, I sacrifice the Avatar of Woe.
Yeah. Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. Alright, this is the game.
Yeah!
I'm gonna discard two cards. I feel it in my bones.
Sure.
okay, thank God.
But first, I'm gonna play an island. And then I'm gonna pass turn.
Alright.
Gaming!
On my upkeep, I'll take a damage. And then I draw a card. Alright. I'm gonna put accumulated knowledge on the stack.
Yeah, that's fine.
Alright, I'll draw a card, right?
Yeah. And then, yeah. Because there's zero cards in the... There's zero accumulated knowledge in the graveyard.
Exactly.
There, gotcha. Alright, take one.
Combat, one pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw.
I can already feel I'm gonna hate editing this episode.
Main one. Yeah, last week's did not sound fun.
It was fine. It actually wasn't that bad.
Alright. I was very tired that week.
Rocky Tar Pit Pass?
Yeah, I think it's our Rocky Tar Pit Pass memento right now.
Untap, upkeep, draw main one. You know how this stuff goes. Okay. I'll play the Swamp.
Swamp.
That was the wrong... My bad. I'm gonna cast Dark Ritual. Does it resolve?
Yeah.
Wait, actually?
I mean, it's counter unless you pay one.
Wait a minute.
So, like...
I'd like to take that action back, because my brain wasn't thinking straight. I'm also very EV this episode.
This episode? It's all... What?
I've quit caffeine, gamers. I haven't had any caffeine in, like, 3 days.
I see.
We're just going to pretend my entire turn was playing this Valdaren Merchant.
Okay.
And I'll make everything happy. I'll discard this Dark Ritual and go to combat, swing for one pass.
So far, go to combat, swing for one pass is doing you pretty good.
It's gonna do it. 16 more turns.
I just have to not.
Well, I'll use this Rocky Tar Pit to find a swamp.
Got
some description.
In.
I'll find the Swamp Island.
Yo, it's the Swyland.
Play a normal island.
Riveting.
And pass my turn.
On my upkeep, I'll take a damage. And I'll
draw
my card.
The second time Brack has done damage!
Just you wait. I've got two more racks in the deck. I don't think I pulled any tinkers either, so I can't even play the one.
Highly funny. A tattoo for a Merfolk Traders.
All right.
Draw a card, and then I'll discard this Ray of Dawnbringer.
Every looter ever printed.
I have 12 effective copies.
Jesus, what are you... I guess you're going for big, dumb reanimation targets. Yeah. I take two.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. All right. Finally, a clock.
Oh, no.
I will pay black, black, black for Underworld Dreams.
Yeah!
And then I will pass turn.
I might upkeep to take a damage.
Yeah.
And then I'll take a damage when I draw a card.
Yeah.
Main one.
That's not good noises.
Yeah, I think we let it rip.
Oh no.
Yeah, maybe.
Do I lose because I drew three lands in a row
I'm
instead
gonna
of cards
that generate
tempo?
Targeting Rhea Dawnbringer?
Oh, hell. Oh, that's not good.
I was at 16, now I'm at 7.
Okay.
And you know, it doesn't give her haste.
Go to combat.
Take 3.
Swing for this much.
Just need a Necrotal off the top. You'll be fine.
I pass my turn.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Jasper, I would have been so happy. I would have been so happy.
So
there
happy.
Are Necrotals in this deck.
Well, we know you discarded...
Oh, I discarded one, yeah.
Yeah.
Any number of them, yeah.
Anyway, there's a rack.
Yeah!
Nice.
I technically still have a turn, unless you can deal 4 damage to me directly through any means.
I don't think I can. On my upkeep, my bad.
Yeah, you get to bring Avatar of Woe back.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have haste, thankfully.
Ooh, but now Necrotal doesn't save you anymore.
That's true.
Oh, but Liz is in danger.
She could just... I could burn her out. She spent a lot of life on Rhea Dawnbringer.
Combat.
She spent 9 life on that.
I swing in for...
7?
7.
All right, down to 4.
Okay.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Okay, well, it's a
swap. I take 3.
So I lose. I lose. Yeah, damn.
Necrotal actually would have saved you.
Yeah!
Damn, that was really close.
Necrotal would have prevented lethal. Man, wow.
Wow, what a close game. Oof, I don't know what to...
It's a good thing I read my cards. I almost didn't side in one of the most important cards for this matchup.
That's so funny. Alright, I think I'm ready.
The cut between...
Are you going first?
Yeah, absolutely. The cut between my incomplete sideboard and my complete sideboard is going to be very jarring.
Keep.
Yeah, I can keep. I'll play a swamp, play the rack.
Nice.
Pass.
Oh my goodness, draw main one. Turn one is going to be a wasteland pass.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. Play an island. Come on, there. Run out the ravenous rats.
Nice. I think I'll discard this guy.
All right. Pass.
I go through the phases. Play an island. Tap 2 for an owl familiar.
Okay.
Pass.
God, where's Waste Knot? Waste Knot would be disgusting in this matchup. Okay. Cool. I will just swing.
Yeah, I'll take one.
Okay, pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw main one. Play a swamp, tap 1. Duress?
Okay, so I have Sengir Vampire and Necrotal, which you can't hit.
Yeah.
Boomerang, Underworld Dreams, Disrupt.
Get rid of that Underworld Dreams.
Okay.
All right. Then I'm going to run out another Merfolk Traders.
All right.
Draw a card, discard Karmic Guide. Combat, swing in for 1 pass.
All right. Untap, upkeep, draw. Main 1. Play Swamp. All right. Damn, you have a 1-2. Whatever shall I do?
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. You know how these things go. Swamp, combat, 1, pass.
1. All right, that's a land. That's an island.
That's an island, baby, which means...
Yeah, sure. Do I? Nah. Actually decided against it.
Fair enough.
I'll just pass.
I'm going through the phases. I'm going to go to combat and swing for 1.
All right.
I pass.
Alrighty. Hymn to Torak. So you have 4 in your hand.
Yeah.
So second from the left.
Dark Ritual.
Okay. Wait. And far left.
Dark Ritual.
Okay. So you just took a bunch of 4 ofs, and you said, yeah, sure.
I mean, yeah, is that not how you build magic decks?
That's, you know what? You got me there. That's valid. I pass turn.
We're just also used to running our powerful upkeep. One of Zach.
Take a damage. Haha.
Finally!
I usually end up cutting down to like three of most things after I put in all the good cards. After I remember, like, wait a minute, I have X busted card in this color.
Pass.
All right, I take one.
That's just the Yu-Gi-Oh brain. Like, why do you even need four Ooh. Copies of a card?
Ooh.
Ho.
All right, I think I'm just gonna hit, let it rip.
Yeah.
Get it twisted.
Get it twisted.
I like how that you started drawing before I let you know if I had a response or not.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you only have one blue, and I don't think there's any unconditional counter. Well, I guess there's Mystic Denial, not Mystic Denial. The one that people
there
play
are
in Commander. Well, yeah, I get that. That's a pretty good
I
card.
I do have three cards in hand.
I will play Swamp.
Swamp.
Hmm. I will pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw main one. These things just go this way. I didn't mean to tap that. But I will tap it anyway to play this Owl Familiar.
Wow.
Draw a card. I'll discard.
We just keep on digging.
Probably this Merfolk Traders.
Are all three of the cards in your hand effective reprints of Merfolk Traders, Liz?
Not yet. Combat. Swing in for two.
We have seen we have seen half of the copies of Merfolk Trader this game.
I have right, four familiars, four draw, of the Voldaren, and four of the Merfolk.
I'll play an island. And then I will pay five.
Oh my god.
Actually this five. For Sengir Vampire.
Nice.
He's here.
A clock!
It's
Finally.
A clock. And now I will attack for one.
I'll block with... I'll take one.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw main one.
The deafening silence of a big thinker.
I was just counting. I was looking at everybody's graveyard. I was looking at cards. Thinking
no,
about cards.
Yeah, like... It's a weird conundrum of whether to riff so that there's full space or whether to just shut up so we can edit it out.
Yeah, fuck it. One black. Reanimate.
Okay, well, I will make you pay an additional mana for that.
Okay.
Yeah, get owned. I draw a card as well.
Nice.
Karmic Guide enters the battlefield, and I lose five life.
Ooh. Okay.
Entering the battlefield lets me pull Merfolk Traders out of my battlefield.
Oh my god.
I will draw a card and then discard a card. It'll be this Avatar of Woe.
Okay.
Alright, big person.
And the Merfolk Traders stays.
Correct.
Oh, wait, yeah, you just moved it. I thought you put it in the graveyard for some reason.
Well, pass.
All right. Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one.
Unless the dead creature is regenerated.
Oh.
I will pay four.
I'm scared.
For Necrotal.
Targeting?
I think it sounds weird, but I'm going to target one of your Owl Familiars.
I think you're right. It dies.
Force the like echo cost check.
Yeah. Well, she can't. She can't pay the echo cost. She has no white.
You can't target Karmic Guide anyway.
Yeah. Exactly. Pro black.
Oh, it has pro black. Okay. Well, that's fine. It can't kill it, and that's what mattered to me.
I'm gonna block with Karmic Guide.
Oh yeah. I guess it doesn't die anyway. Well,
it doesn't die.
Whatever.
Boink.
Is there any other way I could have done this?
No.
Well, there's no way you could have killed Karmic Guide.
Like, other than... Well, no, not the Karmic Guide. It's just, like, I guess I can tap different... I could have tapped differently to keep some of the right mana up.
Yeah, that's always true.
But... I could have thought about it ahead of time. I just didn't. That's fine. I pass turn.
All right, untap. On my upkeep, I do not pay the echo cost, and then yeah! I draw a card. Main
karmic
one.
Guy, like karmic died.
Merfolk traitors.
Oh boy, we're back.
I'll discard this Voldaren merchant. Duress.
Okay. Well, you have three. You have three options. You have boomerang.
I know about that guy.
You've got boomerang.
Okay, I know about that guy.
And you've got a boomerang.
Okay.
And then there's a necrotal in
the
swamp.
Bottom of the stack.
The one on the bottom, yeah. That one. Yeah. It was my least favorite anyway.
So we've now seen 8 of Liz's 12 merfolk looters.
All right, untap, upkeep, draw.
Well, we've also seen the owl familiars. Those kind
of... Oh, shit, I forgot to cut this card.
That's 8 total, right? There's 4 on field and 4 in the grave.
Wait, this is
that's
a sideboard so card. Did I side this in and then side out the color? That's dumb. I love it.
Oh my god.
Awesome.
All right, I'll play a swamp. And I will attack with Sengir, Vampire, and Necrotal.
I'll block Sengir with Owl Familiar, and then I will take 2 to Necrotal.
Okay, and Sengir Vampire becomes 5/5 because of its effect.
Yes.
Pass.
On my upkeep, I take a damage. And then I draw a card.
Oh yeah, the Rack! Totally forgot about that.
Yeah, the Rack is here. She's been doing a good job of keeping ahead of it. Yeah! We got there!
Yeah, I know.
That was the second one, so we're on to game 3.
We're on to game 3.
True.
Wow.
Alright, this is good enough. Yeah, there was a version of this deck that was a lot more red, and then I just cut all the red eventually. I had, like, Goblin Pikers, but they were just filler creatures.
Yeah, I think Goblin Piker is good in
you can
goblins.
Go first.
I don't think it's good in anything else.
It's good in, like, hyper aggro in general, but not in anything else. I cannot keep that hand. This is keepable.
Not keepable. Much better.
I will bottom this card.
I'm gonna bottom this one.
And would you go first?
I accidentally moved it on top. Give me a sec. There we go. Sorry. No, I would like you to go first.
Okay, I will go first.
Indeed.
Play a swamp, mock Sapphire. Pass.
You know how this goes. Swamp. And then I think I pass.
On your end step, I hit recall.
Of course.
Man, imagine having Pot of Greed in a progression-esque series. Crazy.
Underground Sea? Oh, this is mean. I'm gonna do it. I will recoil, targeting your swamp. Return that swamp to your hand and then discard a card.
Cool.
Ooh,
discarding
what the hell?
Goblin Marshal. Hilarious.
Okay.
Whenever it enters
the
battlefield or leaves, make 2-1s.
I see. That's fun. You have some good reanimation targets in here. They're fun.
I do. Austin, fuck you. Get rid of your dual land.
Okay.
I pass.
An eye for an eye, I suppose.
I'm playing this third match purely on spite. I'm gonna make the editor go crazy.
Swamp.
But that's you.
Island. Well, of course I know him. He's me.
It's me.
Island pass.
Oh yeah, baby. This is real magic. Swamp pass.
Using my duelist power, I'm gonna conjure a copy of Force Spike into my hand.
Counter my swamp with a Force Spike.
Untapping, upkeeping, drawing, maining one, you know how these things go. Tap 2 to play this Voldaren Merchant. Draw a card, I'm gonna discard this Ray of Dawnbringer.
It's Voldalian Merchant. Voldaren is the vampires from 4 years in the future. Let me word. There are words in my mouth. Have you ever had a dream that
that you played the Rack?
Yeah, I played the Rack.
I've literally never dreamed.
Yeah, I'll just pass.
Jesus.
But I'd imagine there are some people that are listening instead of watching, and they're being confused by the mixed up terminology that sounds exactly the same as one another.
I don't care about those people.
Wow.
Just actually cruel and heartless.
That's me. We all know it.
You heard it here first, folks. Liz is cruel and heartless, confirmed.
This is rough.
Yeah.
I'm going to cast this dark ritual.
Okay.
I will use it to cast this demonic tutor.
Okay.
One black floating.
With one black floating.
That was fast. Okay, you know exactly what you're looking for.
Then I think I'm just going to tap and cast accumulated knowledge to draw one card, I think.
Yep.
And then combat, swing at you with the merchant pass.
Okay. I respect the accumulated knowledge gambit.
Yeah. I like that card. It goes well in discard.
Yeah.
Goes well in this deck,
I'm
too.
I'm just going to untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Ooh.
Nice sound effect.
Ooh.
Well, I will play the rack.
That's great.
I mean, sure. What could possibly go wrong? I will play Necrotal targeting your fella.
I will never forgive you.
I've done murder. I know.
Untap, upkeep, draw main one. I'm gonna play this Underground River. That kind of bunked my plans, Austin, I'll be real.
Oh, that's good. Did you have, like, a recurring nightmare or something?
Something like that.
Did I get it in one?
I'm going to discard this Karmic Guide. Hey, Jasper, there's this wonderful feature on Discord called Push to Talk, so you can make noises when it won't reveal my hand. I feel like between the two of you, at least both of you have, like, given the other insider information.
He's already playing around it. Like, what do you want from me? You're almost like, you're not losing because...
Yeah, but playing around it and knowing it's in my hand are two separate things. Pass my turn.
Could be victimize, you know? There are other options at the same mana value that are theoretically possible.
Are there? I don't think victimize is printed right now.
Victimize was printed in Urza's Saga.
And I pulled none of it?
I think so. I'm pretty confident it was printed in Urza's Saga. I play a swamp. I will attack with a 2-1 first strike.
I will take 2 damage.
All right, pass.
I do the whole step.
Okay.
Swamp, Dark Ritual.
Okay.
3, Nightmare.
Okay.
Sack the Traitor. Nightmare to hand. I don't know where that happened, but give me a sec.
Oh, you put the Merfolk Traitors into your hand on accident.
There he is. Karmic Guide.
Okay.
Rhea Dawnbringer.
Okay.
Do I get greedy here? Fuck it. 1, 2, 3. I cast Recurring Nightmare Hardcast.
Okay.
I'm going to sacrifice Karmic Guide to get Goblin Marshal.
Okay.
Making 2 1-1s.
Funny tokens.
And it just, oh my god.
Oh, those are good goblins.
Yeah. For me, those are from the Kamigawa set. Is that for you too?
Yeah, it's the Neon Dynasty Commander set, looks like.
Yeah. Anyway, I've passed my turn now.
Okay, on your end step, I will boomerang Rhea Dawnbringer to your hand.
That's fine with me.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Wow. I will pay 4 for Necrotal, targeting your goblin.
Heck yeah. My bad. It then makes 2 more goblins.
Yeah, that's fine. I'll play a third copy of the rack.
Oh my god.
And pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw main one. Perfect. Just as all things ought to be. I cast Unearth.
Okay.
Voldaren Merchant.
Good.
I discard you-know-who.
Mm-hmm.
My bad. I'm going to take a damage from that. So play Recurring Nightmare?
Right, this card still fucking exists. I hate this card. Go ahead.
Yeah, I think you've actually lost the game. Functionally, right? Because unless you can clear these tokens...
Karmic Guide?
Just gonna make...
Karmic Guide brings back Dawnbringer.
Brings back Marshall.
Yeah, Liz has infinite fuel for Nightmare now.
Yeah, but not infinite mana to cast it with.
Yeah, so... Yeah, I mean, do you have Wrath of God?
Not presently.
Ooh, I like the way this game is going. Anyway, combat. Four of these guys can swing.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, no, two, because two of them died this turn to...
Only one of them would have died to Nightmare.
You're so right.
So two of them, four of them can swing? Okay, two of them will die.
Do you have a preference?
No.
I don't care. I'm kidding.
Literally, they are fungible. They are fungible goblins.
They are fungible. I pass my turn.
All right, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. That's not swell. I will play an island. And pass.
Goodness. Untap. On my upkeep, I don't pay any costs.
Mm-hmm.
I get two more goblins. And I'll draw my card for turn. I'm going to play a swamp. I'm going to try to cast Recurring Nightmare.
So...
Yeah.
It has to resolve in order for this to happen. Do I have an opportunity to boomerang it before your priority allows you to do the thing?
I do not think so.
No, actually, I get priority the second it enters the battlefield, which is why... yes! Oh, and one and two! I win!
Okay. I have learned that Recurring Nightmare is really fucked up. It's like,
yeah.
I knew it was fucked up, but it's like, wow!
I
ended up taking it out of this deck, and it might have even worked in this deck.
No, Austin, Recurring Nightmare should go in every black deck that reanimates, period.
It's really good. Yeah, I wasn't really trying to reanimate.
I have two of, by the way.
Okay, I need to... Hi, Reddy, I'm dead.
Wow. I wish I were dead.
If only I could be dad.
I'm surprised that game went so well. I honestly thought you had me in the beginning there.
With hands like these, I don't know how I ever had anyone.
Yeah,
Wow, it only got worse. It somehow just keeps getting worse.
Buddy.
I'll bottom this card and hope.
I'm ready to go.
All
Jesper,
right.
I'm in love with you.
Well, Island Rack, please kill me quickly.
Okay. I'll try. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. No promises, though. Palace, pass.
What the hell? Oh, it's just a...
It's a Lesnian land, yeah. Elfhelm Palace.
All right. Right. Cool. Pass.
Whoa. Untap, upkeep, draw,
I'm not going to go to five. I don't want to go to five, but Jesus.
We'll go Reflecting Pool. We'll tap two for this fertile ground, and we'll put it on the palace.
All right.
And pass.
All right. Oh, yeah, baby. We have a swamp. I will tap two for Sunken Field, targeting this island.
Okay.
Pass.
On tap, upkeep, draw, main one, plains. We'll tap four for the Glimmering Angel.
I can't believe both of you fuckheads got goddamn Reflecting Pools.
Island? Yeah, see, now I'm like, why did I play this at all? Why did I play this deck in the first place?
Upkeep, draw, main one, plains. Then we'll tap two for this Wall of Blossom. Draw a card. And then we will go to combat and hit you for two in the air.
And we'll take two.
Pass.
All right, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. We like to draw the lands, though. Okay. I will tap. Well, hold on. No, because you have the shroud thing. So that's you. You bastard.
Yeah, I noticed this is a little bit fucked up.
Scarred's crazy!
Okay, so how about this? I'll pay 3 for the recoil, targeting your Elfheim Palace.
Ah.
So
okay.
It returns to your hand and the aura goes to your graveyard, and then you discard a card.
Of my choice?
Of your choice.
Of your choice.
Okay, yeah. We will we'll discard the Elfheim Palace.
Yeah, okay. That's all I got.
On end step, will enlighten tutor, putting...
No, you won't.
Ah, yeah, that's right. Okay. Totally
Ooh.
Forgot about that. Shit. Untap.
From the hip, bro.
Draw. Main one. Well, I know you have the Necrotal in hand, so that's unfortunate. We'll go forest. We'll tap it for Rancor on the Glimmering Angel.
Oh, that sucks. Okay.
And, yeah, we'll punch you for 4 and pass.
All right, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Mox Sapphire? Yeah, okay.
Necrotal?
Nope. I'll pay 5 for probe with the kicker. So I will draw 3 and discard 2, and you discard 2.
Okay, I'll discard this Plains and this Slippery Karst.
I'll discard Wheel of Fortune. And a swamp. And that's my turn.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, I take 2. Draw, main one. Will tap 4. Yeah. For Glimmering Angel.
Okay.
Hit you for 4.
There it is again.
Pass.
Glimmering Angel is so good, actually. This is like the perfect aura target. Oh, I didn't get rid of that card. Does that help? Not really.
No.
Island. Jeez. Okay. So I have like 1 turn to figure this shit out? Well, I guess you have no mana right now. He doesn't have blue mana because I got rid of the guy.
It. Yeah, he can't protect it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why I played the second one.
Yeah, well, I suppose I'll kill the one with the Rancor on it just to make you spend the mana.
Sure.
There's no other way I could have done that. Yeah, I'll pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one.
On your upkeep, you did take a damage from the Rancor.
Ah, yes, thank you, Liz. Yeah, we'll go Elfheim Palace, Rancor on the other Glimmering Angel. Punch you for 4. Pass.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Play a swamp. Yeah. I think that's it. I mean, I've got 1 more turn. Unless you have something with haste, but I think that's it.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. School of the Unseen.
Oh my god, that's so base.
It taps for blue.
Oh, so I'm extra dead. Okay.
It turns on Reflecting Pool. Reflecting Pool now taps for blue.
Oh my god. Reflecting Pool is so good.
We'll tap 3 for Ancestral Mask and just kill.
Okay, it was so over. It was yeah, Jover from the start. Okay.
Whap.
That's nice. Wow, what a quick little game.
Okay. I lost, so I will go first.
I will keep.
Okay, I can keep this. Swamp, Mox, go.
Okay, on that upkeep, draw, main one. The unbanned for this one episode, Lotus.
Yep.
Completely forgot, but true.
We will go... We'll play this Drifting Meadow. And we'll blow up this Black Lotus for 3 green mana to cast Yavimaya Enchantress.
Okay.
That's base.
While we're here, because you have no other interaction, I'll cast the recall. Okay.
And I'll pass.
All right. Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. Play a swamp. And I'll just play two copies of the rack.
Okay.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. We'll go forest. We'll tap this meadow for Mother of Runes.
Oh, God. Okay.
Punch you for two. Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. Island. The fucked up thing about Mother of Runes, too, is that it's not another creature. It can protect itself just as well as anything else.
That's true.
Gugh. And there's, like, no cost to it. This is so annoying. All right, I'll just pass.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw. Now I can tap Mother of Runes for stuff.
Ow! I yes. need to remember that summoning sickness is real.
We will go reflecting pool, combat, try and punch you for two. Pass.
All right. Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. It's not exactly what I was hoping for. But I think I will cast the Hymn to Torak. So this is random. So third from the left.
From my left is Slippery Cars.
All right. And the middle.
Drifting Meadow.
All right. Two lands. I will play Rocky Tar Pit. So I remembered that's a land. And that's it.
Okay, I'll be taking two damage from the two racks. Draw, main one. I'll tap three for Yavimaya Enchantress. Oh, this is untapped. Combat, swing, punch you for two.
Okay.
Pass.
Alright, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. I will use Rocky Tar Pit. Oop, that's the shuffle button, not the view button. I will find... This finds a swamp or mountain, so I'll find my island swamp. All right. Now I'll pay five for probe with the kicker. So you discard the rest of your hand.
Armadillo Cloak and Shimmering Angel.
Okay. I will discard Necrotal and Peregrine Drake.
Damn.
And then I will play a swamp return. And pass.
Untap, upkeep,
during
six.
Your upkeep, you take six.
Okay. Main, combat, hit you for four.
Okay.
Fast.
Alright, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. I'll pay two for Hypnotic Cloud without the kicker to discard whatever you just drew.
Swords.
Okay.
Oh my god.
It's happening. Play an island. And then tap three for probe without the kicker. So I will draw three, discard swamp, and swamp. And that's all.
Untap, I'm going to take six. Upkeep, draw. Main one. Punch you for four.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. I'll play a swamp. I will pay three for recoil, targeting one of your Yavimaya Enchantress.
Do I still have to discard a card if you can't target the thing?
The recoil doesn't resolve at all, and no discard happens.
Okay, then we'll use Mother of Ruin.
Okay, the spell will fizzle.
Beans.
Necrotal.
Yeah, I do have a Necrotal.
Yeah.
So, I think that'll target Mother of Runes.
Okay.
But that's all I've got.
Okay. So I'm taking four.
Yeah, you're down to two.
The upkeep draw.
I think an enchantment could do it, but, like, you're deterministically dead this turn unless you can manage to get plus one card in hand.
I can, but doesn't, don't think there's... Yeah, that doesn't do it. Just didn't draw any enchantments that game.
Yeah.
Okay,
that's 1-1?
That's game two. Yeah.
Okay.
I drew that one of Armadillo Cloak, but I I really thought you had the one mana blue counterspell, so I was like, I need 4 mana to cast this.
Mm. Okay. Well, you know, it's refreshing to see a 6-lander after so many 1-landers.
I'll keep mine.
So true.
I'll bottom this card.
I lost the last one, right?
Yeah.
You did.
Yeah. Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Drifting Meadow, pass.
All right. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Underground Sea, pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. City of Brass, then we'll tap two, taking one for Obsidian Acolyte.
Oh, no.
Pass.
Oh, see, Jasper's finally found a way to go to hometown. He's in White Weenie territory, and it's scary.
It's scary.
Stop playing small evasive threats, you dingus. I'll play Sunken Field, attaching it to the island.
Okay.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. We'll tap this, taking one for Rancor.
Oh, no.
Punch you for 3. Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. Play a swamp. Hmm. Oh, that card has pro black anyway. Never mind. I had so many decisions, and then none of them were real. I'll play Wheel of Torture. It's like the rack, That's but it so costs funny. 3 times the mana.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw.
Yeah, I don't have... I'm not playing 8 rack, I'm playing 5 rack.
Fewer we'll than two, 3.
Taking a damage for Fertile Ground. We'll put it on the not the land that keeps hurting me. Punch you for 3. Pass.
Okay, untap, upkeep, draw. Main one. Hey! Who needs friends to give information about your hand when you can just react to every draw like a fucking influencer? It's the rack. The real one.
Okay.
Maybe someday I'll have enough land to cast the discard spells. Hmm. I think what I'm going to do is that fancy trick from last time where I recoil your tapped land to get a 2-for-1.
Okay.
And then you I discard.
At choice? Okay, I'll choose to discard this swords. I mean, what's it going to hit in Necrotal?
Pass.
Untap,
there is a grand total of 1 good creature in this deck, and it's Sengir Vampire.
We'll go School of Unseen. Tap 2, taking a damage. Fertile Ground.
Okay.
Nice.
Combat, hit you for 3. Pass.
All right, untap, upkeep, draw. Main 1. Why did I put that in the deck? I'll play this Lotus Petal, I guess.
Oh, is this where that red card comes into play?
No.
No. There was the initial build of this was a lot more red, and then I realized that the red was basically giving me nothing. But I kept Wheel of Fortune in, basically. And then I sided it out all of the games today because it was a bad idea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for Probe Con Kicker.
Okay.
So I'll draw 3.
And I'll discard 2.
Yeah, we both discard 2.
Oh, okay.
Necrotal and Swamp for me.
Yeah, I'll discard 2 Yavimaya Enchantresses.
Ooh. Okay.
Austin, get rid of that Lotus Petal.
Thank you. I'll pass.
Okay. Untap, upkeep.
I think this is the first time I've put a Lotus Petal in my decks.
And then
you take 2.
Take another from the,
yeah.
From the bad rack. Draw.
Take 1 from each.
Main 1. Plains. We'll tap this just so that Fertile Ground makes a green. Rancor. Combat, hit you for 5.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main 1. Well, I've got Ravenous Rats. Get rid of the final card in your hand.
I'll cycle it.
Okay.
It's a Drifting Meadow.
So you... Okay.
And then you discard whatever you just drew.
It's also a plan.
Okay.
Nice.
If I was playing Mill, that would be optimal. Anyway, I will play a Rocky Tar Pit and pass.
Okay, I'm gonna take 6. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one.
My one?
Combat, hit you for 5.
Okay.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. I think that's it.
Yeah, do it.
Yeah, so I can attack you for 1, and it gets through.
Then and then in my main two,
I have probe. I can pay the kicker. God. Holy crap. It was the ravenous rats for lethal. I could have,
The
only combat damage I did that game was the one ravenous rats damage that determined the entire situation. All right. Well, that was fun. I can't believe I won. I honestly thought I was going to get swept. All right.
Yeah, now it's me versus Jasper.
All right, so viewer context, I did a big oopsie and literally forgot to record the entire third set. So this is the second time we're going around. Oops, sorry. I've hit record this time.
Okay. All right, Liz.
Are you sure?
I just double checked.
I hate this. I'm ready.
I've been chosen. Not that it matters, since you would all, you seems like you want to make me go first anyway.
I keep.
I guess I keep this. Okay, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. We'll play Drifting Meadows and pass.
Nice, untap, upkeep, draw my card, main one. Wasteland. I'm gonna tap it and sack it to get rid of your meadow and pass.
Sure. Okay, untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Forest, pass.
Okay, cool. Swamp, pass. I do nothing crazy.
Draw, main one. Funny. School of Unseen, pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw my card, main one. Island, tap 2 for this guy.
Yeah.
Draw a card. I'm just going to put this Goblin Marshal in my graveyard and pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Oh, poop. City of Brass. We'll tap the City of Brass, taking one for Mother of Runes.
I love that.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw my card, main one. We'll play this island. Recurring Nightmare?
Sure.
Il Goblino.
El Goblino. Pass.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. We're gonna play Black Lotus.
That's good.
Colored. We'll blow it up for white mana.
Oh my god, okay.
We'll use one of the white mana to swords your Goblin Marshal.
Ooh, good call. I gain 3?
Yeah.
Power, yeah.
We'll...
it's a even either way, at least.
We'll tap 3, taking a damage. Not using any of the floating white for Armadillo Cloak on Mother of Ruins.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Then we'll use the remaining 2 for Brilliant Halo on Mother of Ruins.
On Mother of Ruins, okay.
Modern problems require modern solutions.
Pearl P.
So it's a 4-5.
4-5, yeah.
Oh, thank you. Did that?
Oh, I wrong, did. Wrong, wrong card.
Okay, wait, hold on, I'll figure this out. Okay, combat, attack you with Mother of Ruins.
I'll take 4, yeah.
I will gain 4. Pass.
I think that was a little bit more than 4.
I went to from 18 to 22, because I...
You were at 16?
I was not.
No.
It says you...
He went down to 17.
Oh, okay, I see
it
now.
Up to 18, yeah, it's... A little confusing. I kind of wish you could do it all at once, but I don't know of a function that allows you to do that. One.
Frantic Search. Untap. Gonna play a swamp as my land for turn. That's pretty funny. I'm gonna unearth a Voltaren Merchant. Drawing a card, discarding a Voltaren Merchant.
There have been 3 discards this turn, and they've all been Murpho.
Recurring Nightmare. You're gonna call me crazy. I'm sacking... Voltaren Merchant.
I mean, there's no reason to not do this.
I love
and
this
then return
deck,
Voltaren
honestly.
Merchant to the battlefield.
This is my favorite
which draws
deck.
Me a card and then discards Ah, fuck, there's no more Voldaren merchants. I don't have any good options anymore. This accumulated knowledge.
Take 2 damage, I pass.
I'll take 2 damage. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. We'll play the Slippery Karst. We'll tap 3, taking a damage for Ancestral Mask.
Oh no. So it's...
That's plus six.
Or each other.
So it's each other. So it's 4.
Okay, so that's plus 4. Okay.
So it's an 8? Yeah.
8-9.
Fuck.
With lifelink, Jesus. Yeah.
I'll go first.
You want to go first?
No, I'll go second. I lied.
Okay. Jesus. Well, mulligan. I'll keep this.
I'm going to keep this.
And I'm going to send... Okay. Forest Pass.
Alright. Untap, draw, main, Wasteland Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one, forest. We'll tap both of them for Fertile Ground.
Of course you will.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Island, tap 2 for Owl Familiar. I like this one the best. Draw a card. I'll discard this Goblin Marshal and pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. Tap 3. Yavimaya Enchantress. Pass.
God damn it. Untap, upkeep, draw my card, main one.
And Enchantress is a 3/3 because of the Fertile
Ground. Yeah.
It's easy to forget the lands and such.
I'm going to straight up scream. I'm going to play the second Wasteland, just so everyone's aware. Merfolk Trader. Draw a card. Discard Goblin Marshal. Pass.
Yeah. Untap, upkeep, draw.
Why are you laughing, Jasper? What's so funny?
I didn't think you'd be on more than one Goblin Marshal.
What if the first one gets, I don't know, exiled?
Okay, we'll tap 3 for Armadillo Cloak.
The enchantment doesn't tap.
The enchantment itself doesn't tap, but it makes the thing add 2, so whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
So it gets 1 bigger from the existence of the cloak, and then it gets plus 2 from the cloak. Combat, swing at you with a 6-6.
I'll block with my Merfolk Trader to take 4.
And I will gain 6.
You don't take. It has no trample.
Yes, it does.
It does.
It gets trample from Armadillo Cloak. I need to read the card. I forgot that it gives trample.
All right.
Armadillo Cloak's crazy.
Armadillo Cloak is so good.
Oh, thank God. Undiscovered Paradise, but it doesn't really matter, because I'm going to tap 3 for this Mana War, bouncing your Yavimaya Enchantress to your hand.
Sure.
Oof. And that gets rid of the cloak.
And then I'm going to go to combat and swing at you for 1 and pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main 1, City of Brass, tap 4, Glimmering Angel, pass.
No, that tracks.
Yeah, and you already took the damage, I see.
I almost always take it after I tap the City of Brass.
Overass Stronghold.
I don't have the frame of mind.
Hey, Jasper. Fuck you. Second Mana War, put it back.
Sure. Taking 3 this time?
Yeah, pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main 1, forest. We'll use the Fertile Ground for white, Glimmering Angel.
Oh, that's sick as hell.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw, main 1. Owl Familiar. Draw a card. I'm going to discard this Voldaren Merchant. Voldalion. A Budge Million. I'm going to go to combat and I'm going to swing at you in the air for 5.
Yeah.
At end step, I'm going to stack a Wasteland to get rid of your City of Brass.
What do you have here? I'll give Glimmering Angel Shroud.
Alright. Pass.
Okay.
I like how Manowar has reminder text that says draw, if you only have if only one. You have the creatures, you gotta put it
yeah,
back.
Yeah. It's a nice reminder.
Just in case.
We'll tap these 2 for Wall of Blossom.
That's a good card. Fuck.
Draw card. Elfhelm Palace. Land for turn. Pass.
Alright. Untap, upkeep, draw my card, main 1. I like this. Underground River, it's whatever color I want it to be. Tap that for a black to unearth. I want the traitor because I have a fondness for this one. He's been here the longest. Draw a card. I'll discard a card. It'll be this swamp. I'll go to combat. I'm going to swing at you for that much.
Yeah, I'll block one of the flyers and one of the man of war.
Heck yeah, take three.
And one of the flyers dies.
Oh, I know. I'm doing it. And then at end step, I'm going to tap and sack my wasteland to get rid of your white and green land. And then pass.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Elfhelm Palace. Then we'll Rancor on the Glimmering Angel.
That tracks.
And we'll put a Rancor on the Wall of Blossoms.
Okay.
Just for kicks. So now you really can't swing at it.
Yeah. Alright, am I taking four?
Yeah, I'll swing at you, my fort.
Heck yeah.
Pass.
Untap, upkeep. My bad. On my untap, Undiscovered Paradise goes to my hand. I'm gonna play Undiscovered Paradise as my land for turn.
Whoa.
One and a colorless for a merchant. Draw a card. I'll discard this Dark Ritual, okay. Yeah. Colorless, black, demonic tutor.
Okay.
I like this line in the log. Liz puts Dark Ritual from their graveyard into their graveyard.
That's pretty good.
Combat, I do nothing. Then I pass.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one. We'll go Black Lotus.
Oh, fuck.
We'll sack the Black Lotus for green Yavimaya Enchantress.
Oh, that's pretty big.
Five.
Elfhelm Palace and Forest. Brilliant Halo on the Shimmering Angel.
On the Angel again? Okay.
Yeah. So he gets plus one power. Plus two toughness. And Yavimaya Enchantress is 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's a 6/6. Combat, swing at you with a 5/4.
I'll block with my 1/1, so I'll take 4.
Yep. Pass.
Alright, untap, upkeep, draw my card, hope it's good, main one. My untap, Undiscovered Paradise, but I'm going to play it as my land for turn.
Undiscovered Paradise is so good. It's one of the cards I was least happy to not pull any out of Visions.
Those three, my bad. For Recurring Nightmare?
Sure.
I think I still lose here, don't get it twisted.
Yeah, it's not a great spot.
View graveyard. I'm going to pull up this Goblin Marshal by sacking probably the Merfolk Traders, yeah. It's going to make me two goblins. Yeah. Then I'll pass.
Okay. Untap, upkeep, draw, main one.
I don't think I win here still.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, it's unlikely.
Punch you with the Glimmering Angel.
I'll take 5.
I think that's all we're gonna do. Move to main 2. Yeah, we'll play this plains fast. Like, it'd be annoying if Elfhelm Palace got blown up again.
Damn. God damn it! No, I don't win this one.